Hello, I'm Flash Isaac and welcome to WAEC Topics. Today I'll be taking you through physics syllabus. Now when you see the physics syllabus, you'll be wondering, if it's syllabus, why is it still covering almost all the topics? Syllabus doesn't actually tell you the topics not to cover, it doesn't exclude many topics from your textbook, but it tells you what to read under every topic. It streamlines your reading. So it guides you, because sometimes you can read too much and still fail. That's what you call reading out of points, reading off point. So you need to read within points, within range, so that at least what you read will be something that will come out in the exam. I'll be taking you through the WAEC physics syllabus for you to know where WAEC sets most of their questions. Now take a look at the WAEC syllabus for physics. So part one, you're expected to know about interaction of matter, space and time. Matter is anything that has mass and occupies space. Matter can exist in different forms, and we have particle nature of matter. The particle nature of matter states that matter is made up of different particles, which are atom, molecule, and ion. An atom is the smallest particle of matter or element, which can take smallest particle of matter which can take place in chemical reaction. And atoms also have subparticles, which are proton, electron, and neutron. Proton are positively charged, electron is negatively charged, while neutron is neutral. Atomic number is the number of electrons in an atom. So just count the number of electrons in an atom, you get the atomic number. While the atomic mass is the number of proton and neutron, the nucleus of the atom, inside the atom. That's what makes up the atomic mass. And matter can exist in different states. Matter is basically the things we see around. For example, water is matter, chair, phones, everything around, they are matter. So when you see something that is very strong, like this mouse, this solid is strong, and the force of attraction between it is very strong. This solid. Then water is liquid, it can be poured. It doesn't have particular shape. It's any container you pour water, that's the shape water will take. Then you have gas, air, smoke, so those are gases. So the force of attraction between them is very weak and they can be compressed. So those are basic matter. Matter can change from one state to another. Water in liquid form, once it's heated, it begins to evaporate. That means it's going to gaseous state. When you put water in your freezer and it's on, after some time, it gets blocked, very strong. So water in liquid state has now frozen, it's now a solid. So matter is being changed from one form to another. So those basic stuff about matter, change of state, matter atomic theories are the things you are supposed to know in WAEC chemistry under the first session. Now let's see. They need to know about quantities, fundamental and derived quantities. We have two quantities in physics. Fundamental are quantities that exist on their own. Other quantities are gotten from fundamental quantities. The top three fundamental quantities are length, mass, and time. Now we are looking at velocity. Velocity is change of displacement with time. Speed is distance over time. So speed is a derived quantity. So but they are just getting their nature, they are existing because of fundamental quantities. Speed, distance, time. Distance is fundamental, time is fundamental. Velocity, acceleration, change in velocity over time. All their units and derivation are gotten from fundamental quantities. Okay? You need to know all these things and their dimensions. You need to know about motion, types of motion, random, translational, and other types of motion. You need to know about speed and velocity, the difference between speed and velocity. You need to know about rectilinear acceleration. And one main difference between speed and velocity you should know is that speed is a scalar quantity. It doesn't have direction. Why? So scalars and vectors. You should know about scalars and vectors. You should know the Newton's law of motion. First law, second law, and third law. Okay, let me just introduce you to the laws. The first law of motion states that a body at rest will continue to be at rest. And if it's in motion or moving, it will continue to move until a force is applied to stop it. The second law says that the rate of change of momentum is mass times velocity, is proportional to the force applied and takes place in the direction of the force. And the third law of motion, Newton's third law, states that action and reaction are equal and opposite. For example, if this is staying here and I'm pressing my hand towards this, this is the action. The resistance of the hand is equal to the action, but it's in opposite direction. The more I hit the wall, the more I feel pain in my hand. So this is the action. The reaction is equal to the action that I am applying. So those are the summary. And part 2 of physics syllabus for WAEC covers energy, mechanical and heat energy, basically energy forms, then work energy and power. You should know about heat energy and how energy can be transferred from one form to another. And don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.